Hello, I'm Ben Chewy from TV35. Today we're at the Cranford High School Film Festival. I'm with Mr. Carraza. Thank you for meeting us, sir.
Nice to be here. All right.
Very excited.
What is this today, and how is this different than the other film festivals this theater has had?
Okay, so this is a film festival that's exclusive to the high school students in town. Not just the high school students, any student in Cranford. But we really have been trying to grow the film program at the high school for the last 3 or 4 years now. We've had a lot of student interest in making films and making films at the higher level. And so in the past, students have really had to rely on their own resources and do it sort of on their own free time. But with a lot of support, we were finally able to get equipment into the classroom through several grants and funding from the district. And we were able to really kind of get the film club up and running. We've been able to add some new courses. And now we have students making films sort of constantly, all day, every day. So, you know, we really wanted an opportunity, especially for the students in the fall, to be able to showcase their work. This town already offers a fantastic film festival in the Cranford Film Festival, which does have a student film section. There's also the Garden State Film Festival, which is featured here in town. And so my spring students have that opportunity, but for the students I have in the fall, we really wanted to make sure they also had a chance to showcase their work.
Sounds good. Was there anything in particular that got you to have this event?
It was really, you know, student interest. A lot of students had been making film and they wanted a place for people to see it, you know. And so again, most of what I do is not for me. I don't have a film here. It's for them to have that opportunity to really showcase what they can do.
So how often do you expect this to be? Is this going to be like every season, or is this every year, or that kind of thing?
I think it's going to largely be an every year thing, as long as there's that interest and the students keep pushing out work. I think we're going to try and continue to do it in the winter, again at the end of that fall semester, to showcase that work from those fall students. Again, those spring students will have their own opportunities through the Cranford Film Festival and such.
What do you hope that students learn from presenting it like this, instead of just, you know, in the class and all that?
We were actually just talking about that today. You know, we talked about how art can make a difference. It shows us what makes us human. It's an opportunity for them to see things that they've worked hard on, that they've put countless hours into, for them to see that they created something. They've made something that's real, that's tangible, that people are paying money to see tonight. And I think that's really exciting. So, you know, that'd be my big takeaway.
Now I'm with the student president of this film group. So I'm with
Alex Schneller.
Thank you, sir. So, what was your involvement of all this?
I helped plan some of the film festival. I also submitted two of my own short films with the help of peers.
Nice. So, what made you decide to get involved with all this?
Well, I really enjoy films a lot, and I think it's a cool way to express yourself. I enjoy creating art and things like that, so I thought it was cool.
Very nice. What do you hope to gain from having your film on the theater instead of just in class and all that?
I think it makes like your vision more real. I think it's really cool to see what you made in theater, and I also think it helps you bring recognition to what you've made, and if you want to submit it other places, I think this is a nice place to gain the confidence to do so.
And do you have any film ambitions once you get to college?
I mean, make more films. Get it accepted to some more film festivals, you know, and we'll see where it goes from there.
Best of luck.
Thank you.
All right, next up we're with
Jason Knight. So I worked in 3 different films that were in here. One I completed myself, which was a narrative short. It is called Cycle. It is about the time that we have away from our priorities and how to spend them and to just really pay respect to your time that you have. And to not just forget those extra hours that you can spend alone or with friends. Otherwise, I worked in 2 projects with groups. One was a documentary about businesses in town. We called it Standing on Business, and it talks about the importance of small businesses in Cranford. We actually got up close and interviewed businesses like Witch Baby and Periwinkle, and I'm really fortunate to learn a lot from that. Also, I worked on one last one, which was another narrative. This one was a short film, though, and it was called Mania. It is the film I'm most proud of from this class. I worked with two really close friends, one being Alex Schneller and Stefano Giorgio. We worked really hard. It turned out really good. And I think every minute of it lives up to all of the time that and hard work that went into it. But yeah, it's definitely an awesome experience to show them to everyone and to really get the use of the public and to spread attention to how great the film club and film classes in the high school are.
Oh, 1, 2, 3.
It's good. You just, you need to edit it again.
You don't even want to keep it?
No, just come back when you finish editing.
I want to thank the students, as much as they might, drive me nuts and, you know, keep things till the last minute, every once in a while and keep me sweating. The stuff that they were able to make this semester has really blown me away. So I really want to thank them. The support I've gotten from, you know, my department, from my supervisor in the school, you know, this wasn't possible 3, 4, 5 years ago, and now it's happening, and it's, you know, I think just a part of the fabric of the town now.